Hello and welcome back to Manufactio. Since last time I've been working on the next step we needed, and that was a way to make gears. I also pushed back the wall here a little bit because it was just getting too tight. But I did notice one thing that we should actually do. Let's replace this chest. And I also put covered on there just because I think it would be nice not to pick up everything when I walk along here. But I figured out that these bins will actually output into these inventory chambers. That's something I did not believe it would. So, slot 0. If I just have, let's see, how much? No, actually, I'm just gonna rewire this whole thing. I don't need it. I actually don't need any of this, to be honest. All I need is this output. I will just rig from there to there and say slot 0. That's not 0, that's 0. And I want 800. Oof. Now, when it is above 800, which it is, it should output, I believe. And what's this one set to? Too high. You want it low. Oh, that's it. And we can start from the bottom and be done with that. That's much easier. No need to mess around with chests with multiple slots and whatnot. So let's quickly empty out here. As you can see, I have a lot of heavy engineering blocks. I set up this one over here, so it can do heavy engineering blocks. I also have the mechanical components here. It is way cheaper to do it that way. So we may make a few of these for automation of various kinds. But it means that I do have almost everything I need. I also had a look at processors. Turns out that my entire factory here, all of this, with the exception of the sulfur production, this is actually a separate facility, but these can be reduced to just a few blocks. And that is definitely worth doing. I just need a bunch of red circuits to get started. But first I think I'll do the gears, because they are way faster. So let's just grab a bunch here. 2 stacks, that should be okay. Ah, 3 stacks. Now I got all those. And I still got sulfur coming in up there. I don't know. It's just weird. Don't know where it's coming from. But what we need, I need a chunk loader at some point. Need these things. For these we need aluminium plates and control circuits.
That
won't get us very far. So let's just pick up a stack or two. Oops. Hardened stone and iron. I'm really out of iron. Apparently I am. Well, fortunately for me, I got a good reserve over here. So let's just pick up this one. It's only 32,000, I think. We got plenty of redstone and flint, and yeah, that mistake is still haunting me. I have an extractor somewhere. What's it do? So let's just quickly set this one up. This and like that. And it'll just slowly empty it. That's fine. You'll get iron all over this. Good enough. We were looking for aluminium. I just got slightly distracted there. That, I believe, is aluminium. Yep. Silver and gold. We'll just do one stack for now. Okay, that's... yeah. We may be able to pick it up. But we not. We just have to see. But I should be able to... so just go completely bonkers here. So we just break this one, and there we go. Now we got all of this, and so let's make some machine structure blocks. Now I did not make a building for it, because I have no idea how much space we're going to take up. I got everything. The most expensive part here is actually the red circuits and the heavy engineering blocks. I think I'm going to need at least 20 of them. As I said, I don't really have a count. I just made a bunch. Let's see, a lathe. I need steel plate, steel rod, and user interface. Do I have a user interface? No, but I've got one more red. Rods, steel rods, yep. No steel plates there. Oh, that's not. Oh, steel components, steel ingots, not red stuff. Just dump the mechanical components over here. And I think I need a little bit more electro. Plates. No need to. Oh, we needed the user interface. Oh. Now. Lathe. There we go. And let's see. What we wanted was gears. These things. And for that we need a lathe and a rolling machine. Okay, so next up, rolling machine, steel gears. Ooh, that's a different one. Do you have any steel gears? Maybe. No, that's iron gears. You're making those, so... 1, 2, 1, 2. And let's just get a few quick steel gears. Oops, I ran into the smoke. There's my rolling machine. Now, this is not all we need, but... let's see, over here. I don't know if I'm going to use the basement. I decided to convert it into concrete hole here, just because it seemed a good thing. And I actually think that we'll be starting down here. What's that? That's not what I want. Can you please disappear? I want one rolling machine. Because that's the first thing I need. Let's see. Let's output... I wanted to output that way. Yeah, something like this. So let's see, the machine structure goes there, goes there, there, and there. We need coils. And power input, fluid input. Now the thing is, I don't really get a list of what I need for these things, so I just have to work it out. Okay, so fluid input. I need a bucket. I don't have a bucket. Bucket, bucket, bucket. Go, plenty of buckets. So, one bucket coming up. That's the fluid input. And we need power input blocks. We need a redstone battery. No, that's not redstone batteries, that's energy cells. Didn't I have? Oh, that's for... I wonder, can that be used? I'll have to try it. Nope. So how do we make this? Sulfuric acid, iron, and copper. Right here. Oops, we had one there. We do need one more though. But, let's do that as we come along. Other way around. There we go. And what was the other things we needed? We needed a couple of chests. I think I got the chests in here. There. Let's get over here. Oops, we need coils. I think we just use copper coils. Because they are easy enough. And I don't think they do any difference to the machine. Yeah, I got a cold. Bad one. Been completely down for a few days. That's not so nice. So, coils. Power block. Fluid in. That's two output hatches. Should be covered. I don't know, surprised this one ran out of ammo. So a creeper decided to visit me. Fortunately, it only made a small hole in the ground. It did not get into the factory itself. But it was pretty close. Okay, and shift scroll up. Let's see. Rolling machine goes there. Need two machine structures. And two input hatches. So making 20 of these was actually not that far off. All I need now is the engine thing. Let's just see how we can make that. I made a creative world where I could test this out. Putting in the best engines actually speeds them up to an insane level. I think we got those, copper coil blocks, electric engine. Yeah, I've got plenty of those. Yeah, plenty of those. I wonder. Where do we have those? Power? No. Military? No. Science? Automation? Here it is. Actually, if I got 100 of those, I'll just have a look. We might as well go for the better engines. There to despawn. There. I just want to see what the better engines are like. If they are indeed worth it, easy to make. There we go. And that was A41. Yeah, that one is not gonna happen. A01. Oh, got these. I wonder what they're for. That's for vehicles. Electrum coil block, titanium. Do I have electrum coil blocks? No, I don't have them. So we'll just stick with the other ones. These, it'll speed up a little bit. But it's okay. Now, these machines actually work quite well with the immersive engineering machines. And poop. There we go. Look at that. Hey? Eh? That's pretty cool looking. And if I remember correctly, these actually turn when it's running. So, yeah. I don't think anything is running through it. But we'll have to see. So, we need lubricant in here, and we need iron plates in there. So, back we go. And let's see. We need pipes. We might actually need more than that, but we'll see. And we needed lights and ducts. And what we don't need right now is that concrete. Yeah, well, we'll start with that. And just see how it goes. That side. Magnet bone full of thingamajiggers here. Well, we got a chest. So everything we don't really need right now, we'll just go into that chest and we'll be done with this. On. I'm sure we have covers somewhere, so we can actually cover this up. Sometimes I've seen that when I dig out, I find cavities below. And that's actually where zombies have tried to enter. There's an input hatch, and that's another input hatch. They are two separate inventories, at least that's what I saw in my testing. I did notice one was missing up here. There we go. It's the circle. And I think I would put a filter on it as well. And filter. And we'll just upgrade those. So that they are the nice kind. And we just need to grab one plate. And put the filter on. Next thing up will be the fluids. And you can shift for 16. And control gives you one, but that's the same as this. Alt will do nothing, so you only have the shift thing. Prevent oversending. Yeah. We'll whitelist iron 64 iron plates. Now that should result in there always being 64 in there. If need be, we can send the other inventory as well. Go. Power wise, it's not the cheapest, but we'll see. So, next up, we need lubrication. Where do we have any lubrication coming? Well, we got fluids here, but we need a fluid filter. Do I have one of those? Good question. Oops. Yeah, I got two of them. So. I think I can input from underneath. I think it can. looks up to be you. And I don't think I got enough pipe. No, I should have it. Let's see if this will work. Wow. Let's see, we need to line up here. And off we go. Whoops. I forgot about the hole. Go. And it's time to get this one filled in. Get this in. Buckets, this one has 64. Oopsie. Oh, I'm out of ammo for this. Well, last thing we need. Power. So power is easy enough. We'll do. No, not you. Just dump a few things in. I need a post. At least temporarily. The idea is I will be making a building around. I think I need a couple of posts. I think the closest we have down there is actually LV power, and that won't cut it. It's sufficient for running this one and running the pollution pump, but yeah, there's LV. Got MV there, that's LV, that's MV. Go. Ah, that's brilliant. Then we'll just make it with a few more steps. And last, the connector. There. Now this one is not outputting anything yet until I switch it on. Oh! See? Now it's running through. And out comes iron sheets. Now these, what's that? Carbon scrubber cartridge. I can do whatever this is with two of those and lubricant. I can do a lathe and get iron gears. So where did my hollow projects go? That's all the way down here. Hollow projector. Let's see. I think I can place them here. That's output. Input, output. Yeah, I think I need to. I want it this way. Yeah. Except I want it one closer. There. That's where I want it. So, let's just quickly grab our materials here. We need these. Well, yeah. I got chests. So one input, one output. That's pretty easy. Now we need output at the bottom. And input at the top. Then we have two machine structures. Just place that one temporarily there. Get the lathe thingy from there. Goes there. We need the power input. And that required a couple of iron plates. Now I want five of them. And five copper plates. Together with a bit of one pocket of sulfuric. I think that was what we needed. These. Yeah, sulfuric. Do I have sulfuric in here? What's that? Oh. Do I happen to have here? That's lubricant. Okay. Let's get some. Why is that one? It's creosote. Yeah, I got thing, small tanks sitting all over the place. Oh! Well. We just use this. And get over here. Let's see, that's sulfuric, iron plate, copper plate, a crystal, let's see there, that's a new, I just need. Oh, now I got two of them. Ah, never mind. There we go. And then we need one motor. Which I think we can do as well. Nope. I'm missing all the parts because I dumped them up there. Ah, that's my life. I leave things all over the place. Here we go, and let's see, I need this and that. Can't get rid of those yet. Don't need any of that right now. Need these and these and these. Then I should be able to make my motor. Yeah, one will do. Now, I don't actually know if these machines are polluting or not, but we quickly see. I don't think they are. Ooh, that's another cool looking machine. Servos are down here. No? Ugh. Must have dumped them. Now, power input was at the bottom. So I wonder, can I reach from there? No. Cannot. But putting that one there should solve that. See? This one will just fill up. And I don't know, can I? No, I can't. So I actually need. Now, I'm just curious, how is this inventory keeping up? It's doing okay. It's doing okay. So, servos and filters, and I should be able to make gears. Servo. Filter. That should be it. With this, my gears should be coming. Now it is a question of speed. How fast this will go. I'm guessing that it's not going to be fast at all. Oops. That whitelist. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. That's a mistake. This is where it goes. And you go there. Let's just see what it does. There we go, iron gears. And if I I did not want that to happen. Okay, well, one more thing, and we'll be done. Now, given how fast this actually goes, I think I might want to set up a few more. Oh, we forgot. That's full of dirt. Never mind, I'll set up one of those between episodes, I think. And there we go. Oh, I didn't notice that. So out you go. It's not as fast as the other one, but I can't just break this machine, upgrade the motor, and have it go faster. But with a view of these new machines, I'll say bye for now, see you next time, where we continue with our improved machines.